The Campbell Barton Student and Alumni Association at the National Security College would like to invite you and a friend to the Association's first NSC Movie Night on the 29th of April 2016. The screening is free, it's HD, and food and drink are provided. This month's film is 1975's 3 Days of the Condor, a classic post-Watergate paranoia thriller directed by Sidney Pollack and with great performances from Robert Redford, Faye Dunaway, Cliff Robertson and Max von Sydow. Based on James Grady's 1974 novel 6 Days of the Condor, the film follows Joe Turner, codenamed Condor, a motorized bicycle riding, technically savvy, comic book reading analyst who works at a fake literary society that is actually a front for a small CIA team that looks for secrets hidden in plain sight.
We read everything that's published in the world. And we feed the plots, dirty tricks, codes, into a computer, and the computer checks against actual CIA plans and operations. I look for leaks, I look for new ideas. Who'd invent a job like that?
Of course, the film was a thriller, so Condor soon stumbles into a conspiracy and finds himself on the run from sinister forces, unable to trust anyone in the agency. The film was ahead of its time in many ways. Remember, it was released in 1975, around the same time as the birth of the internet, 14 years before the World Wide Web, and a quarter of a century before social media. As well as the use of computers to find secrets hidden in books, Condor uses his telecommunications technical know-how to engage in a kind of semi-analog hacking of the telephone system. The film also depicts the, slightly fictionalized for the time, process of cross-referencing computer databases to search for a rogue element within the CIA.
Oh, be damned.
Perhaps most remarkably, although the bogus American Literary Historical Society was the invention of the then 24-year-old author, according to the defector Sergei Tretyakov in the book Comrade J by Pete Early, when Russian generals saw the film in 1975, they thought that the small team depicted in the film represented a genuine CIA capability, which partly inspired them to set up a similar department within the KGB. Although the Soviet version had over 2,000 workers. 3 Days of the Condor holds up pretty well as a film for modern audiences, given that it has no car chases and no explosions. There's also a rather odd codependent kidnap romance in the middle of the film that drags. But overall, the film has survived as a classic of the genre, and has not only spawned several sequel novels, there's also a TV series in the works. So come along to the Springbank Room at the National Security College on the 29th of April 2016 for a free evening of food, drink and 1970s intrigue.